technology. It's always watching us, studying our every move. And it just focused its attention on Carol Peters.
Thanks so much for being here, Carol.
What is this?
Let's jump right into it.
I don't like this. Why is it doing that? I'm gonna find out who you are, okay?
Carol, I am a technological superintelligence. I can control every dollar and every machine on the planet.
The duty, I think, of storytellers and filmmakers to talk about the kind of invisible tethers that hold humanity together as much as they talk about the things that tear us apart. Superintelligence at its heart is a movie about humanity itself being the greatest weapon we have, about people wanting to save people, about our essential goodness. I know that when I come out of the movie theater, it's my favorite time to have a conversation. You know, you talk about your favorite scene, the joke, the big action moment in the movie. The conversations walking from the theater into the car are the best. And people, when they find out that I wrote Superintelligence, always want to talk about artificial intelligence and technology. They want to have that conversation.
The media industry, just like other industries, is going through a digital transformation. And that transformation has been accelerated in a way that we were not expecting, that we were truly amazed about, but also so grateful that we were able to participate in over the past year and a half during the pandemic. The media industry needed to reimagine itself. It needed to engage in panels like this. It needed to create entertainment that would reach people in their homes, as opposed to reaching people in theaters or in other locations where they couldn't actually be. So thinking about digital transformation and the incredible acceleration of digital technologies to connect people, to connect them with entertainment, to connect them with gaming, to connect them through meetings, and to allow companies to engage in productions of their events. You know, this has required extensive technology, extensive data, which always brings up the issue of privacy. People want to know that when their data is being used, when their data is being accessed in order to engage online, in order to engage through apps, in order to engage in the precise way that we're engaging here, that their data will be treated respectfully and that their data will not be used for purposes that it shouldn't be used for purposes other than this kind of precise engagement. So privacy, having controls over data, these are the kinds of things that the media industry, just like all industries, need to aspire to do as this industry engages even more deeply in technology. And frankly, in some ways, this industry, because movies have been around for over a century, but media industry, more than almost any other, is constantly reinventing itself. And the entertainment industry is constantly reinventing itself.
I started thinking about the connections between privacy and film, and there are many. On the one hand, like Julie was saying, film is such an important part of storytelling and of how we view ourselves and the kind of culture we create. On the one hand, it reflects culture, but on the other hand, it also creates it. So in that way, it's really important for film to allow us to understand better our digital world, because on the one hand, digital tech is very intuitive and very easy to use, and so on. At the same time, it's incredibly opaque. So one of the marks of data is that it's very invisible. When somebody collects your data and sells it and does something untoward with it, you usually don't learn of it until much, much later. So film in this sense can make things that are invisible to us much more tangible. It can explain to us the kind of journey that data goes through from the time it gets created to the time it ends up in the hands of a company or a government or a data broker or insurance or something else. And so in that sense, it has an incredible opportunity to make our world more understandable. And essentially, there are two visions of technology that are arising. On the one hand, we have something that could be called authoritarian technocracy or something like that, with China, big state that really believes in surveillance and uses surveillance in very invasive ways and in a collaboration with companies. And there is a push in the West to create technology that is more sensitive towards democracy and that protects democracy. And these two models are very different. And the kind of narratives that we build around them will be crucial.
I develop mobile apps in the entertainment space. I have created apps that have reached 1 billion people around the world. And I've been using data and artificial intelligence to basically create entertainment experiences for over a decade. I previously made music apps using machine learning to help people make music on their phones. And my current company, Hooked, is in the storytelling space. Hooked is the number one mobile storytelling platform for Gen Z. We tell stories in three formats: text, audio, and video. And we have reached over 100 million viewers around the world. And the secret to our success is data. We basically use data to determine which IP to produce and to basically test IP at different stages of the development funnel. We collect data to understand which stories are resonating with audiences in text format. Essentially, we test scripts. And based on what the data is telling us, we decide which original IP to produce. As a result of this, we have produced several original shows for our mobile platform that have reached hundreds of millions of viewers around the world. But also, these shows are incredibly diverse. And the reason that we're able to do this is because our data allows us to take a risk on unproven creators, on diverse storylines, on new faces, and prove before we're investing significant money, prove that there's actually demand for those stories. And so we are able to really use data and artificial intelligence as a force for good. Stories and film in particular, they reflect our culture, but in a lot of ways, they also help move our culture forward. And I believe that as storytellers, it's our responsibility to make sure that we are at the cutting edge and we are telling stories that reflect our world as it is, but also the world that we want to create.
We've already seen that, and we just heard that whether a story is a good story is basically, it's inter alia based on data, which indicate whether a story would be liked. And my question is, but is this liked because people have liked similar stories in the past, and are they therefore likely to like this one? Or would they perhaps be ready for something totally new? Or as Monty Python said at the time, and now for something completely different. Or perhaps that's completely different is perhaps not so much there anymore these days. Although I would think it is particularly useful and necessary, more than useful. AI can also, we can have now script. We not only can identify storylines and endings and target audiences, but scripts can be written by algorithms. Music scores can be written by algorithms. We can have deep fakes replacing actors, or we can have ghost actors. All that is possible. Within the Council of Europe, our governments think that it is necessary to come up with some rules, which is why working on this possible AI treaty, I can tell a bit more about it later. But the basic idea is we should not just leave it all to self-regulation, as it's called, not just leave it just to the industry. There must be some basic rules, as on data protection and artificial intelligence, that would guarantee that we keep diversity and that we adhere to certain standards when using all these wonderful technologies to make sure that they remain wonderful and do not become a menace. Thanks very much.